In recent decades, robots have taken over many jobs previously done by workers. Are massive job losses on the horizon? To what extent has automation already had an impact on employment and wages? This paper sheds light on those questions by studying the impact of industrial robots on local labor markets in the US over the 1990s and 2000s. Over that period, there was a steady increase in the stock of industrial robots in both the US and Western Europe, with the increase in the former roughly equivalent to one additional robot per 1,000 workers. To help frame the issue, consider two key ways in which robots can affect labor demand. The first, called the displacement effect, reflects the common concern that robots will have a negative impact as they displace workers from tasks they previously performed. The second, called the productivity effect, suggests there is also a countervailing positive impact. Because automation increases productivity, it allows firms to produce more output, and this requires hiring more workers for tasks that can't be automated. This increases labor demand, and empirically, the net effect will depend on the balance between these factors. An initial look at this relationship in industry-level data reveals several notable patterns. First, there is considerable variation in the rate of robot adoption across different industries, and the correlation between adoption and labor market outcomes is negative. Industries with higher adoption over this period also experienced a decline in wages and employment. Moreover, improvements in robotics are uncorrelated with other major trends, including increased import competition from China, offshoring, and investments in IT. Given these patterns, this paper's main question is, what are the implications for local labor markets? Put another way, what has happened to workers in markets heavily affected by robot adoption? A major obstacle in answering this question is that the prevalence of robots in a given market is tightly linked to other factors, such as actions by labor unions, that also affect employment and wages. So how do we isolate the channel we're interested in from these other effects? The author's strategy is to rely on industry-level differences in rates of adoption. Using commuting zones, or CZs, as their local markets, they ask, given employment shares at this local level in 1970, and the subsequent evolution of different industries over the 1990s and 2000s, which geographic markets were most likely to be exposed to robot adoption over that period? To illustrate, consider two hypothetical CZs. In 1970, the majority of workers in the first market were employed in the automotive industry, while the majority in the second market were employed in the furniture industry. Over the 1990s and 2000s, the automotive industry as a whole was a heavy adopter of industrial robots, while the furniture industry was only a modest one. As such, based only on these industry-level differences, we would expect the first market to have experienced greater robot adoption over this period. To further ensure that this measure is not linked to contemporaneous local conditions, the authors rely on industry-level patterns of adoption from Europe, which leads the US in terms of robotics. The idea is to use differences in adoption rates derived from technological advances rather than those derived from US-specific factors. The results show first that CZs with greater exposure to robots, as predicted by the author's measure, do in fact adopt more robots over this period. This figure shows the positive relationship between exposure on the x-axis and the number of local companies, or integrators, that install, program, and maintain robots in that CZ. This figure shows the main results of the paper. Even after controlling for a number of demographic, industry, and local labor market trends, there is a strong negative relationship between exposure to robots and changes in both the employment-to-population ratio and log hourly wages. In other words, greater exposure to robots reduces employment and lowers wages. The authors find these effects are mostly concentrated in routine, manual occupations, and hit the hardest for those at the bottom and middle of the wage distribution. The corresponding magnitudes suggest that the adoption of one additional robot per 1,000 workers in a CZ reduces the employment-to-population ratio by 0.39 percentage points, and hourly wages by 0.77% relative to a CZ with no exposure to robots. Put another way, one robot reduces employment in the affected market by 6 workers. Note that these numbers incorporate both direct and indirect effects. As robots displace workers and unemployment rises, the negative effects spill over to other local businesses, such as restaurants and retail stores, further depressing employment and wages. The results so far speak to the local effects of robots, but what are the implications for the broader economy? While automation reduces employment and wages in a given market, it also generates benefits for the rest of the US, for example, by reducing the prices of goods produced by robots. Quantifying these broader effects requires making a number of assumptions, and so the results should be interpreted with some caution, but the authors estimate that the aggregate effects of robot adoption are still uniformly negative. Even after accounting for positive spillovers, one new robot reduces employment by 3.3 workers. In conclusion, this paper finds large negative effects of robots on employment and wages. Because there are still relatively few robots in the US economy, the authors estimate that the total number of jobs lost so far has been fairly limited at only 400,000. Though, of course, these effects could grow as robot adoption continues to advance over the next few decades. To delve deeper into this topic, you can check out the full paper and its references to other related research. These include papers studying the effects of technology on a wide range of labor market outcomes, including wage inequality and employment polarization. And within this broader category, research focused more particularly on automation and industrial robots.